So I just finished watching the movie Precious, and watching this as an adult is just mind-blowing. I remember sitting in the movies next to my own mom watching this movie, and I didn't know what to expect. I don't remember how old I was, but I remember a lot of emotions coming through my body. But then watching it now, I still even teared up because it's just like, how many of us have went through trauma like that? How many of us have dealt with abusive parents? How many of us have dealt with verbally abusive parents, physically abusive parents, parents who have taken our trust, have left us in places and situations where their trust was taken away because of something that they've done to us? Growing up in the inner city, I know that my mom would party with friends and I would be left home alone. My parents were separated. My dad lived on the other side of Staten Island and I didn't see him for like 2 years. And that just kind of left me in my own domain, 5 and 6 years old. I remember living in the peas, going across the hall to wake up, you know, the friends that my mom had created. And I'm walking all up and through their house. Everybody's knocked out. The fact that I could even do that is mind-blowing. You know, when you're thinking it's normal, I'm trying to wake up people and everybody's dead, fast asleep, like, couldn't move, in food comas, knocked out. Just thinking about these things, you know, it's bringing back some memories. I picked up a friend's book. It's about healing childhood traumas, and it's like, do I want to pick this up? You know, I think it's just exceptionally powerful how everyone that I know is on a healing journey, and I'm thankful. Sometimes you don't even get to heal those parts of you until you are older. You know, I know that there are people around me who are just not genuine or have some jealous or envy that doesn't make sense to me, because I'm gonna wear a $5 outfit, a couple $100 outfit, like whatever dollar amount you want to put on it, and I'm still gonna look bad, and I'm as in a good way. You know, I don't feel like I have anything that warrants jealousy or envy, but sometimes it's just the way that you carry yourself, and people will never know what you've gone through. They just see the exterior, and because my exterior is shiny, it's healed, and sure, I have some bruises and bandages like the one I just got on my knee, but it's like people just don't realize that you have some serious internal scars. And just watching a movie as simple as that could trigger so many memories for me. And it made me really sad because I don't have a solid relationship with my mom. I never did. And watching that movie just made me think about that. And I'm like, you know, it's almost as if there's a Bible verse where it talks about how the woman would be bruised, or, you know, she would now have to go through trauma with childbearing. You know, she's going to be cursed, you know, because they ate of the fruit of the tree. And I feel like one of those things was the relationship with women. Like, you, because you didn't obey in the garden, you now also are going to be, you're going to have tumultuous relationships with your daughters. It's just so sad, you know. I can't speak for everyone, but I know that a lot of people have difficult relationships with their moms, whether sons or daughters. Sons call themselves mama's boys, but they speak to their mom in the most wildest ways. And the relationship between them is not always good, but they'll do anything for them. They'll listen to them top notch before they listen to anybody else. It's just mind blowing. And as much as we honor the Black woman, you know, she is the mother of all civilization, you know, under Mother Earth. And it's like these people have the worst experiences on Earth. But, you know, from what I understand now, as the patriarchal society finally crumbles, the matriarch society is going to rise up again. And I always say it's really going to be important for us to make sure that we continue to stay on a up and up and the rise up of our Black men, because they're going to be phased out just like the patriarchal society. So it's going to be important to continue to honor them. So many women I know are making more than their counterparts and making more than their husbands. And it's like, why can't their fathers just stay home with the kids? You know, like, why is that such a terrible thing? And I love a provider. I love a leader. I love somebody who can lead the home. But it doesn't mean that just because the woman is making the money that he still can't be a provider and a protector. And I think that's going to be important for us to remember and recognize and adhere to. You still have to honor the person of your home. Just because you make more money doesn't mean that they shouldn't earn your respect or have your respect. And I think that we're going into a phase for the next, you know, 6,000 year cycle, 6,400, 6,700. I always hear conflicting numbers, but it's like, until we go into the next age, you know, we're here and we have to realize what's about to come from this, you know, new heavens and a new earth. I pray 2025 will be, you know, a revolutionary type of environment, and 2030 will be even greater. 2025 will be so great because it's a 9 year, and this is going to be like a golden year, an era of divinity and leadership. We're going to see some type of, what's the word, dictator rise, and that's going to create a mass hysteria, possibly a war, depending on who will be the next president. Either way, it's not going to be good. I can keep forgetting that this is an election year. And I think they're going to let us play outside for the summer. I think that something will be announced in the next 40 days. I know that there was going to be a lot of judgment after this eclipse season. We have till the end of the week to find out what's happening. There's going to be more stories coming out about people and their energy being disrupted from this. There's going to be a lot of mental health issues coming out. There's going to be a lot of people with overdoses or addictions. It blows my mind how much people cannot live their lives without a substance. And I always like quit things when I know that they're going to be a fad or when I feel like they're going to be a problem. It's almost as if I'm ahead of the curve, you know. And I always speak about marijuana and ganja being, you know, super different, and how marijuana is about to be something that creates addictions. And if United States was wise, they would know that all 50 states have to be legalized in order to maintain their status as being number, you know, top country of the world, because it's crumbling and they owe us reparations. And, you know, we are going to have to skip out of town, if you will. And I think that they're going to try to prevent us from doing that. I'm talking wild on here right now. They're about to shut my shit down. But I said it all to say, going back to Precious and thinking about these traumatic events that I've experienced, and, you know, it allows me to be this person and to have these premonitions, to have these dreams, to have these thoughts, to feel these energies, because I always knew I was different. But I don't know what that comes with. You know, the mother of Precious was jealous of her daughter because her man wanted her and her man didn't want the mother. And it's like, I don't know if that ever happened to me, and I'm not saying that it did, but I've always felt like there was a sense of jealousy in that relationship that I've had with my parent. And it's just unnecessary. You know, like, I've had conversations where it's like, you know, you took my life away. And I'm like, I didn't take anything from anyone. We are the only people who can control our lives. So if you felt like you didn't do what you were meant to do in this, you have to take that up with your creator, because I'm not trying to repeat this cycle. I'm not trying to come back to this earth. I'm just trying to ascend and move on, you know. And watching this movie just opened my eyes to so much, and it just opened my eyes to who I am and why I need to continue to ascend and excel my career forward. I love my family. I'll do anything for them, but I've stopped talking to more people in my family than I have regular as people, aka friends, or people who I thought were my friends. You know, like, I've embraced those relationships more than I have with my actual family. I don't know who I can trust, you know, and I just need to keep these boundaries high and firm and know that, you know, I have the Lord on my side, and know that, you know, I'm going to always continue to embrace who I am and my purpose, my divine purpose here on this planet, you know, just talking to people and getting to know people and understanding that we all have our differences, but yet we all have our similarities. We're all human on this planet trying to escape reality, because please believe this is like some type of jail. It's like a soul jail. And I shouldn't even say soul jail, because I don't believe everybody has a soul. You know, I believe some people are genuinely here just roaming around, just wasting their life away. You know, I see hustlers on a street corner still, and I'm like, how old are you? Why is this your life, bro? Like, you don't want nothing better. But then I remember that some people genuinely don't feel like they're gifted or given any other cards. It's like, if this is who you are, why live? You know, and then I think about how some of these people may have been gifted artists and capable of doing things with their hands. I mean, if you're rolling blunts, you obviously had a talent of using your hands at one time. So it's like, if you had a talent and if you didn't use it, better believe, and I believe this firmly, that God gives your gifts away. So why? Just don't waste your life away. People need to put down drugs and alcohol. I'm tired of going out with people and all they want to do is drink. And it's crazy because I could drink so much now. I feel like I'm old. You know, like the OGs never get drunk or whatever. And it's like I feel woozy for like 5 minutes in and I'm like, okay, I'm back. You know, it's like I don't know what happened. So I don't even bother anymore. And over this weekend, that was the first time I drank since December. And I'm just like, I don't understand why people spend their money on this shit. And I'm not here to judge, but there are some people who genuinely have problems and they don't really understand what life is like without a substance. And we need to get back to healing. What are you running from? Why does this substance need to run you? Why do you have to have a drink every day? Why do you have to smoke every day? When I was smoking heavy, I was running from my own trauma. And when I cut it down, no more facing blunts. I'm taking a pull or two a day and then just moving on with my life. And I would be taking it because I was working like a psychopath. And then I realized the correlation between me smoking and working. And then when I stopped working, I was like, why am I still smoking? Oh, I like to do yoga and smoke, or my meditative states are higher, or I'm now smoking to be a little bit more creative, or I'm smoking this sativa, you know, to kind of allow me to get focused and maybe write my book for XYZ amount of hours as opposed to taking a pill. You know, I've never done any other drug outside of alcohol and weed, and I don't plan on doing any other drugs outside of that. People are always trying to tell me to get into shrooms and how I'll be able to regurgitate some past life traumas and da da. I'm like, nah, I'm cool. Whenever those things are meant to be revealed to me, I believe that they will. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I don't know what these white people be putting in drugs no more. And I don't want to fuck with it. It's just as simple as that. And I feel like people need to be a little bit more awakened to these commercialized things. You know, weed is no longer from the ground. It's made in a fucking lab mixed with this, that, and the third. Like, it's just so crazy, bro. Like, this planet has become a shit show, genuinely. Take me to a place where things are still organic and thriving, you know, I could eat off the ground or eat out of the tree and rock with some indigenous folk. Like, I just need some authenticity in my life. Someone asked me today, where do you want to live? And I'm like, wherever the sun is. That shit had me on 11. Like, just bring me to the sun. I'll figure all this other shit out. Like, I just want to be back in the sun. But that's all I got. I just wanted you to hear my thoughts about Precious and some childhood traumas that kind of came up. And, you know, this is my life. Peace.